You're wondering what you could expect the Greater Lakeland area real estate market to do in the first quarter of 2020? Today we're going to take a look at some facts, figures, and some predictions. Some of you are going to love them, maybe others not so much. So strap in, here we go. "2020 is going to prove challenging for home sales. We're seeing a shift happening right now. Because the Greater Lakeland area is so diverse and has so many different communities with different price ranges, we have to look at these projected trends with this in mind. The good news is homeowners and buyers alike in the $150,000 to $250,000 range will continue to see high demand. But with that will also continue the inventory shortages in this price range. We're in the middle of January, and as you can see, there's been 27 homes sold in this price range so far, all of which have sold on average for 100% of list price. This trend will continue, with one exception. Home sales are going to dip. It's already started. I'm predicting that we're going to see approximately a 1.8% decline in existing home sales. In the Greater Lakeland area, we're also going to see prices starting to flatten, meaning that we're not going to see that spike of home values that we saw in 2018 and 19. So you might be wondering why this is. Well, we already know that home values are remaining consistent. And if you're a homeowner, that's good news for you, especially if you own a home in that median price range. So why the prediction of the decline of home sales? Keep in mind, the entire country is just now unraveling and bouncing back from the worst economic downturn and real estate disaster in history. So who are our buyers now? It's no surprise that over 35% of our home buyers are millennials, and another 27% of those home buyers are Gen Xers. Tight supply and more stringent lending guidelines, 2020 is going to prove challenging for this pool of buyers, who make up well over half of all of our buyers. But not because of what they can afford, but because of what they cannot afford. Millennials, especially Gen Xers, are extremely smart buyers. They have done their homework weeks in advance before even calling a realtor to see that first home. And they're not settling either. Gone are the days of buying the starter home and waiting a few years to upgrade. They're demanding pristine condition move-in ready homes, and they're skipping the traditional paths that their parents took when investing in their first home. And if they can't find it, they're willing to wait or put off home buying altogether until it does become available. This trend is crystal clear right now in the Greater Lakeland area. Hence the reason for the prediction of the decline of home sales for the first quarter in 2020. Let's take a look at a higher price range and how different these scenarios change. We already know that the average home value in the Greater Lakeland area is about $227,000. So why has home sales so far this year have an average of $275,000? Yet home sales are dipping a little bit. It goes back to what we just talked about. The majority of buyers who are skipping the starter homes and opting in for that upgraded home are outweighing the buyers for those other lower priced homes. Because there's more homes to choose from in this price range, competition is a little bit stronger for these homeowners. I'm predicting that we're going to see a higher percentage of list price reductions for this price range. And also, I believe that some homeowners are also going to opt to take their house temporarily off the market for now. In this price range so far this year, there's been 27 price reductions, opposed to zero in 2019 this time of year. We're also going to see an increase of total time that these homes sit on the market before selling. Quite a huge difference for this price range. Home prices above $400,000 only make up about 13% of all homes in the Greater Lakeland area. There are currently 111 homes listed for sale in the Greater Lakeland area that are $400,000 or above. Of those homes, only one has sold this year, opposed to triple that in 2019. Overall, I'm seeing an increase in list price reductions and also an increase on total days on market. And I believe that this trend is going to continue through the first quarter of 2020, with an upturn in the second quarter. But I still believe that January is the best month to sell. I know that sounds a little contradictory what I just said, but you'll want to watch my earlier video that explains in detail, and you'll understand why I said that. So the bottom line to the Greater Lakeland Area real estate forecast for the first quarter of 2020 is, if you are a homeowner and your home value is $250,000 or less and is in pristine move-in condition, you are still in the driver's seat. And for sellers in that 300 plus range, be prepared for your realtor to suggest a price reduction or a seller concession. That is, if your plans are to sell this quarter. Otherwise, you may see an increase in days on market. And for buyers in any price range, inventory is going to remain tight for a little while. My personal advice to you, get all of your finances in order. Have your lender provide you with the strongest possible pre-approval letter. Also have 10% of your purchase price in the bank. So when that ideal home does come along, you'll be in a solid financial situation to beat out most of your competition. For some awesome tips and guidance on getting your offer accepted, you're going to want to check out my earlier video, My Top Secret Methods for Getting Your Offer Accepted. I'm Lisa Kelly, Lakeland Homes and Lifestyles with Premier Realty. And if you're still unsure of where you stand in this real estate market and you'd like to have a consultation based on your individual circumstances, I invite you to fill out the short form below. It's titled, Tell Me About Your Plans. I personally answer each and every one of them. Did you find this video helpful? If so, hit like. And please let me know if you'd like to see more quarterly real estate market forecasts for the Greater Lakeland area. Just leave me a comment below. Until then, I'll see you on the next one.